Now, in today's lecture, we are focusing on tetragonal crystal system only. Okay, so in tetragonal crystal system, we are having total 3 axes. Okay, so A1, or you can name it as A, B and C, where A and B are same. So normally we name them as A1 is equals to A2, which is not equal to C, which is the vertical axis. Okay, angle between them are alpha. Alpha is perpendicular to beta, is perpendicular to gamma, which is equals to 90 degree to each other. Okay, so these are the basic relations about the axis or the crystallographic axis of this particular crystal system. Now we will discuss about the characteristic properties of this particular crystal system. Okay, so there are two properties which are general properties of this crystal system. First one is two axes of equal length are there. Okay, so we are having two axes of equal length in all the crystal classes, and which are interchangeable because they are of equal length. So we can name them as A1 and A2, and this can be interchangeable because of equal length. But we cannot interchange it with C because which is of different length. Okay, so A1 is equals to A2 and C, and A1 is equal to A2, which is not equal to C. Okay, and the second one is, in all the crystal classes, one axis of fourfold symmetry is always present. ठीक है, कभी कभी एग्जाम में ये क्वेश्चन पूछ लेते हैं फ्रॉम द करेक्टरिस्टिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर क्रिस्टल सिस्टम्स. ओके, सो क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क लाइक के कौन सा ऐसा क्रिस्टल सिस्टम है जिसमें सभी क्लासेज में फोरफोल्ड सिमेट्री एक्सिस प्रेजेंट है. ओके, सो द क्लास विल बी टेट्रागोनल क्रिस्टल सिस्टम, नॉट एग्जैक्टली क्लास, द सिस्टम विल बी टेट्रागोनल क्रिस्टल सिस्टम. ओके, सो टोटल देयर आर 7 क्लासेस एज वी डिस्कस अर्लियर. द नॉर्मल क्लास ऑफ दिस सिस्टम इज डायटेट्रागोनल डायपिरामिडल. नेम ऑफ द क्लास इज डायटेट्रागोनल डायपिरामिडल, एंड एग्जाम्पल इज जिरकॉन टाइप. ओके, जिरकॉन इज द एग्जाम्पल. The HM symbol for this is 4 by m, 2 by m, 2 by m. Here if we talk about the symmetry of this, here we are getting one axis of fourfold symmetry, two axis of twofold symmetry, and these are two diagonals. Okay, let's see if this is the cross section of that particular axis. This one is A2, this one is A1, and this axis, which is vertical. So we are representing this crystal, this is the holding position, but we are representing this crystal as this form. Okay, in this form. So this axis, which is moving front to back, is A1, which is moving left to right is A2, and the moving which is up to down is C axis. Okay, so these are the basic representation. Okay, so here these are the two axes, and along with these two axes, because these two axes are equal, we are getting a square shape here, and because of this we are having two diagonals also. Okay, so this 2 by m, second 2 by m, is represents the diagonal. So here we are having two diagonals of twofold symmetry. The total symmetry of the class will be, I will be present because of the presence of center of symmetry. Okay, after that 4 8, one axis of fourfold symmetry and four axis of twofold symmetry, along with total 5 mirror planes are there. Okay, this represents C axis, so one mirror plane on C axis. This represents two axis. Okay, so two mirror planes on A1 and A2, and this also represents two axes, or rather two diagonals, that is D1 and D2. So here including all these things, total 5 mirror planes are there. So this will be the symmetry of the particular class. Of the name of that class is tetragonal dipyramidal. Okay, now we will move on to the HM symbols of the particular classes of this tetragonal crystal system. Okay, so these are the HM symbols. This one is the first, second, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. ओके, सो दिस फर्स्ट पोजिशन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग सी एक्सिस, दिस सेकेंड पोजिशन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग ए, ए मीन्स एक्सिस दैट इज ए वन एंड ए टू. सो दिस पोजिशन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग टू डिफरेंट एक्सिस विच आर ऑफ इक्वल लेंथ. ओके, एंड दिस पोजिशन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग डेफिनेटली टू डायगोनल्स दैट इज डी वन एंड डी टू. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट वन इज द फर्स्ट एच एम सिम्बॉल और फर्स्ट क्लास ऑफ दिस इज टेट्रागोनल पिरामिडल. ओके, सिमेट्री इज 1A4 बिकॉज वी आर हैविंग ओनली वन एक्सिस ऑफ फोर फोल्ड सिमेट्री. ओके, सो लेट्स ड्रॉ द एच एम सिम्बॉल ऑफ दिस. दिस इज 4. हियर वी आर ड्रॉइंग अ सॉलिड, ओह सॉरी, डॉटेड सर्कल बिकॉज वी आर नॉट हैविंग द मिरर प्लेन ऑन दिस. ओके, एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड earlier that if we draw a solid line it means mirror plane is present. Okay, and if we are drawing a dotted line mirror plane is not present. Okay, here on C axis mirror plane is not present, mirror plane is not given here. Okay, so mirror plane is not present on C axis. So when we were discussing the rules of this HM symbols, we have discussed that the mirror planes on the vertical, on the axis will be shifted or will be represented on the perpendicular of that particular axis. Okay, so it will be reflected on this plane. Okay, and this axis which is C, it does not have any mirror plane. So we'll draw this circle as a dotted circle because this is just the stereo net, or on this plane only we need to draw or represent this whole crystal. As C axis does not possess any mirror plane, so this plane will not be a mirror plane and we'll draw this plane as a simple dotted circle. Okay, this is, after that we'll draw diagonals, sorry, axis A1 A2. We need to draw it because here the spaces are empty, but to show or to get the HM symbol, for our reference we are drawing it. Okay, so this is A2 and this is A1. The axis which is moving front to back in this holding position will be A axis, the axis which is moving from left to right will be B axis, and the axis which will be from top to bottom will be C axis. This is the proper holding position of a crystal. Okay, so these are the basic structure, this will be the basic structure of the HM symbol of this class. After that we need to put the symmetries. Okay, so here we are having four fold symmetry on C axis, so we need to draw a square which is solid on C axis. Okay, C axis is represented by, okay, so we have put it this four fold symmetry on the C axis. Now we are taking a motif. Okay, so let's assume that this is our motif. Okay, now what was the initial definition of four fold symmetry? Four fold symmetry means if we are rotating the crystal to 90 degree and we are getting the same face, then only it will be like four fold symmetry. So here four fold symmetry is given, so after rotating the crystal to 90 degree we will be getting the same face. Okay, so this is exactly 90 degree if we are rotating the crystal along this axis, because symmetry is present on C axis. This is C axis, symmetry is present on C axis, so we need to rotate the crystal along this axis only. Here this is the position of this axis, so we are rotating the crystal along this axis only. Okay, so this is shifted here after rotating it to 90 degree, we are getting the same face which is dot. Okay, again rotating it to 90 degree we will be getting the same face, again rotating it to 90 degree we will be getting the same face. Okay, so this will be the HM symbol of this particular class, that is 4. Okay, second one is 4 bar. Symmetry is definitely 1A4 bar, and the name of the class is tetragonal disphenoidal. Okay, So now we'll see the HM symbol of this particular class 4 bar. Okay, here also we will be drawing a dotted circle because of the absence of mirror plane on C axis. Okay, after that we will draw R axis, that is A1 and A2. Okay, after that we will put the symmetry which is present on C axis. Okay, so this is like lens inside a square, which is the representation of 4 bar. Okay, now we are taking our motif here. Okay, so what we have discussed earlier, that 4 bar means 4 fold plus inversion. Okay, so we have to rotate the crystal to 90 degree and then we have to invert it to fulfill this operation. Okay, so now we are rotating the crystal to 90 degree. Initially we are getting this face here. Okay, and we are inverting this crystal along this point to 180 degree, because inversion is definitely 180 degree. Okay, so we have to invert this crystal along this point. So this is initially here, okay, not here, but I am representing it here because I am not getting this final dot at this point. Okay, so we are rotating the crystal 90 degree, I am getting a dot here in this position and I am inverting it. So after inversion it will go here. Okay, so we have seen this thing here, na? This is inversion. Okay, similarly if we are inverting this point along this, if we are inverting this B along this point, we will be getting this. Okay, so this is the axis, let's assume that this is A2, we are inverting this B object along this point and we are getting this. Okay, so similarly here after inversion we'll get this point here, but as this point is above the plane, okay, so if this plane, this point is above the plane, is this is facing towards you, na? Right, let's assume that this is a tetragonal system or the class is 4 bar. This is not 4 bar class, but you have to assume it. Okay, so this is the particular face which is I am representing it by dot, because this is pointing towards you. Okay, or above the this perpendicular plane, I am rotating this crystal to 90 degree and I am inverting it. Okay, so after inversion it will go downward, which is initially above this crystallographic plane, this stereographic plane. Now this is downward. Okay, so this will be represented here as a hollow sphere, not sphere, hollow circle. Okay, so this will be the representation of this particular class. Again, this is the first operation is over for this 4 bar symmetry. Okay, again we have to rotate the crystal because we have to rotate the crystal to 360 degree, right? Here we have rotated just it to 90 degree. So again we are rotating it to 90 degree. We will get a open circle here and after inversion, we have to definitely invert the crystal along this point. So after inversion, here this was coming here. So we were getting a open circle here at this point and after inversion, we will get a dot here. Okay, we are inverting this crystal along this point, so we will be getting a dot here. Okay, again operation is not fulfilled because we have rotated the crystal to 180 degree. After again we will be rotating the crystal to 90 degree, we will get this circle or this point here, which is a closed circle or dot. And after inversion, initially this is dot here and after inversion we will get a open circle. Okay, so we are getting a open circle because we have to fulfill the operation here. Operation is telling us to rotate the crystal to 90 degree and invert it. Okay, so we are rotating the crystal to 90 degree and inverting it to fulfill the proper operation or to satisfy that operation. Okay, so this is our initial figure here. After this we have to rotate it again to 90 degree because here we have rotated it to 270 degree only. We have to rotate the crystal to 360 degree. So we are again rotating it to 90 degree, I'll get a open circle at this point, open circle at this point, and after inversion I'll get a dot here. So from here we have started and we are getting a dot again here. So this is the proper representation of the four bar crystal. Okay, so this is the proper representation of four bar crystal. Okay, so जो आपका कन्फ्यूजन है वो दूर हो जाना चाहिए, क्योंकि वी हैव टू डू टू ऑपरेशंस साइमल्टेनियसली, दैट वी हैव टू रोटेट द क्रिस्टल ऑल्सो एंड वी हैव टू इन्वर्ट इट ऑल्सो. आफ्टर इन्वर्जन, इफ दिस इज द क्रिस्टल, ओके दिस इज अ पर्टिकुलर क्रिस्टल, दिस इज अ फेस हियर. आफ्टर इन्वर्जन द फेस विच इज अबव, ओके इफ वी आर रोटेटिंग द क्रिस्टल टू 120 degree and we are inverting it, after inversion the face which was above initially seen, now it is, we are seeing it below the perpendicular plane or the stereographic plane. Okay, so that will be represented as, if the crystal is above a plane of reference, we are representing it by as a dot, and if the crystal is below that point, we will be representing it as a open circle. Okay, so we have to rotate the crystal to 90 degree and invert it, so we'll get a open circle. Again rotate, again invert, again rotate, again invert. Okay, so this is the proper HM symbol of this particular class. Okay, after that we'll be moving on to the third one, that is 4 by m. Okay, 4 by m. So what is 4 by m? Here it is saying that we are having a mirror plane on C axis. Okay, so this is representing C axis. So it is telling us that we are having a mirror plane on C axis. It means we will draw this circle as a solid circle because of the presence of mirror plane on C axis. After that we will draw our axis. Okay, which will be dotted line, because no mirror planes are present on the other positions. Okay, we'll name them A1, A2 and C. Okay, this point is representing C axis. Okay, so this is the proper representation. After that we need to satisfy these two symmetries. We have to fulfill these two symmetries. Okay, so this is a square here on the C axis. So this is the basic structure of the HM symbol of this class. Mirror plane is already placed. Okay, now I am taking a motif here. Okay, if I am taking a motif here and I am having a mirror plane, okay, so let's assume that I am having a face which is this, and I am having a mirror plane on this plane. Okay, so the face which is here will be reflected as it is, which is below that plane. Okay, face will be reflected same, because we have seen that the mirror plane is bisecting the crystal into two equal halves. Okay, the face which is here will be reflected here. Okay, so we have to represent the same face two times on a particular position. So the face which is here will be as it is reflected on the surface which is besides or behind this plane of representation. Okay, this is the basic stereo net or the plane of representation. If I am having an object here, okay, if I am placing an object here and I am putting this board or assuming this board as a mirror plane, so this object will be reflected as it is behind this blackboard or this board. Okay, so it means that we have to represent the particular face on a particular position. So a face which is behind the board will be represented by the open circle, and the face which is above the board will be represented as a dot. Okay, so this will be the basic representation of the HM symbols. Okay, after that we need to satisfy this four-fold symmetry. Four-fold symmetry means we have to rotate the crystal to 90 degree and we will be getting the same face. Okay, the same face means the same face will be above the plane of representation and below also. Okay, again after rotating it to 90 degree we will be getting the same face. again by rotating it to 90 degree we'll be getting the same face. Okay, so this will be the proper stereo diagram or stereo net for the class 4 by m. Okay, after that we'll move on to the 4 2 2. Okay, 4 2 2 4 2 2 4 2 2 means this will represent C axis, this will represent A1 and A2, and this will represent D1 and D2. Okay, here till now we were not drawing diagonals, but here at this position we are having diagonals also. So we will draw dotted circle first, and dotted circle means absence of mirror plane on C axis. We will draw axis also dotted axis because of the absence of mirror planes on the axis as well, and these are the two diagonals which are also dotted. Okay, which are also dotted. Okay, so now we have to put these symmetries on the particular axis. This is C axis, so I am putting a square here. The two axes are having twofold symmetry, so I am putting lens on the edges of the axis. Okay, so these are the axes, and on the diagonals as well we are having a twofold symmetry, so I am putting these two lenses on the two diagonals as well. So this is A2, this is A1, this is D1, this is D2. Okay, so now if we are taking a motif here, okay, this is a motif here, we need to rotate the, if we want to satisfy this symmetry first on which is present on the C axis, we can do that also. But if we want to start with the symmetries of the axis, we can do that also. It is totally up to us which symmetry we need to satisfy first. Okay, so if I am taking the symmetry of A axis first, I need to rotate the crystal along this A axis to 180 degree. Okay, so if this is the crystal, this is the holding position, this is the axis of rotation, this is C axis, but let's assume because I am having the face here, this is the axis of rotation. Okay, so if I am rotating the crystal to 180 degree, okay, if I am rotating the crystal to 180 degree, and if this is the axis of rotation, so face of reference will be this. Okay, this will be the face of reference. We are rotating the crystal along, this is the axis of symmetry. Okay, let's assume this is the axis, C axis, holding position is like this, that. Okay, we are rotating the crystal along this axis, which is A1, A2. Okay, so if we are rotating the crystal to 180 degree, it will be the face which is initially above the plane of representation will go behind the plane of representation. Okay, so after rotating it to 180 degree, we'll get a open circle here. Okay, because of the rotation of the axis along this A1 axis to 180 degree. Okay, again we are encountering this twofold axis of symmetry. Again we need to rotate the crystal to 180 degree along this axis, so we'll be getting a dot here. Again we are encountering this twofold symmetry. Again we have to rotate the crystal to 180 degree. After rotating it to 180 degree, we are getting a open circle. Again we are encountering this twofold symmetry, we are getting a dot. Again after rotating it to 180 degree, we are getting a open circle. Again if we want to rotate it to 180 degree along this axis, we'll be getting a dot. Again if we are rotating it to 180 degree along this axis, we'll be getting a open circle. After satisfying the symmetries which are present on the axis and diagonals, simultaneously we are satisfying the symmetries which is present on the C axis. You can check it. After rotating the crystal to 90 degree, we are getting the same face. Again 90 degree we are getting the same face. Again 90 degree we are getting the same face. Again 90 degree we are getting the same face. Okay, so this will be the stereographic projection of this, or the HM symbol for this particular class. Okay, after that the class is 4mm. 4mm is symmetry is one axis of four-fold symmetry and total four mirror planes. Here these are representing two axes and these are representing two diagonals. Okay, so 1A4 and 4M. The name of the class is diatetragonal pyramidal. Okay, 4MM. So the class is 4MM. This is representing C axis, this is representing A1, A2, and this is representing D1 and D2. Okay, so let's draw the circle. We will draw a dotted circle because mirror plane is absent on C axis. After that, we will draw these axes as solid lines because of the presence of mirror planes on axis as well as diagonals. Okay, after that, we'll put four-fold symmetry on this C axis. Okay, so the basic structure is complete. Two-fold symmetry is not present on the diagonal, so we will not represent the two-fold symmetry on the axis as well as diagonals. Okay, so now this is A1, this is A2, this is D1, this is D2, this is C. Okay, so now we are taking our motif here. Okay, if we want to start with the symmetry of C axis, we can do that also. But if I want to start with the mirror planes, I can do that also. It is totally up to us in which way we want to start. Okay, I am finding that this, the starting of HM symbol or symmetry satisfaction, satisfying the symmetry along these axes will be more easier. So I'll start with the axis or satisfying the symmetry of the axis. Okay, so I am encountering this A1 axis first. So this is a mirror plane. Okay, so if we are an object, we are having an object here or a face here. Okay, a face is here and mirror plane is present here. So reflection of this face will be seen here, right? Same face will be seen here. Again, we are encountering a mirror plane. So same face will be seen here also. We are again encountering a mirror plane. We are seeing the same face here also. We are again seeing the same face here also. Again encountering a mirror plane. Due to the mirror plane, we are encountering same face here also. Again mirror plane is present, so the same face is here and same face is here also. After satisfying the symmetry of the mirror planes, we have definitely already satisfied the symmetry of the C axis. Okay, you can cross check it. Okay, so this is the HM symbol of the particular class, which is 4MM. After that, we will move on to the 4 bar 2M. 4 bar 2M symmetry is 4 bar 1A 4 bar, definitely two axes of two fold symmetry and two mirror planes are there. Okay, so the basic structure of 4 bar 2M is, basic structure of 4 bar 2M is, we are having a dotted circle because of the absence of mirror plane on C axis. Okay, after that we'll be drawing the axis will be dotted because mirror planes are absent on the axis, and after that we'll be drawing diagonals because the third position is representing diagonals, right? We have discussed this earlier. This is representing A1 and A2 axis, this represents C axis. Okay, so we are drawing diagonals as solid lines because of the presence of mirror planes on the diagonals. Okay, after that we'll put a 4 bar symmetry here and 2 fold symmetries on the axis. Okay, now I am taking our motif here. Okay, first, if I want to satisfy the symmetry of this C axis, I can do that also. But if I am to move with the axis and the diagonals, I can do that also. It's totally up to me. Okay, I have discussed this earlier also. So I am starting the symmetries or satisfying the symmetries along with the axis. Okay, so here when I am moving the crystal to this way, I am encountering two-fold symmetry. Two-fold symmetry means rotating the crystal along this axis to 180 degree. If I am rotating the crystal along this axis to 180 degree, the face which is above the stereographic plane
will go behind the stereographic plane after rotating it to 90 degree. Okay, oh sorry, 180 degree. This is the proper face. If I am this is the plane of reference. If I am rotating the crystal to 180 degree, the face is towards me, which was initially facing away from me. Okay, so this will be a open circle here. Okay, now again I am moving this side, I am encountering a mirror plane. So what does a mirror plane do? Mirror plane reflects the thing as it is. So I'll get a open circle here. Okay, after that I am getting a two pole symmetry. So for two pole symmetry I have to rotate this crystal along this axis to 180 degree. So I'll get a dot. Again I am encountering a mirror plane. So mirror plane will be this. Again I am getting the two fold symmetry. Two fold symmetry means rotation of crystal along this axis to 180 degree. So I will get a open circle. Again mirror plane is this, and here I am getting a two fold symmetry and mirror plane is present here. So I'll draw a dot here. Okay, so this is the representation or the HM symbol for this particular class, that is 4 bar 2 m, and this 4 bar symmetry of C axis is already satisfied. You can cross check it. Okay, after that we'll be discussing the class which is 4 by m 2 by m 2 by m. This is the normal class of the particular this is the normal class of this tetragonal crystal system. Okay, after that here I am representing I. Okay, what this I means? I means center of symmetry is present in the class. Okay, center of symmetry is present in this class. So as center of symmetry is present in this class, I am representing it with the help of I. Okay, after that I am getting a four-fold symmetry or four-fold axis of symmetry on C axis. So here one axis is four-fold axis of symmetry, here two and here two, total four axis of two-fold symmetry, four axis of two-fold symmetry, and total five mirror planes, that is one on this, two on this, and two on this. So total five mirror planes are there. Okay, so this is the symmetry of this particular crystal class, and the name of the class is ditetragonal dipyramidal. Okay, so we'll see the HM symbol of this class, that is 4 by m 2 by m 2 by m. Okay, now we'll draw a solid circle. Because of the presence of mirror plane on this C axis, which will be reflected on its perpendicular plane. Okay, after that I'll draw these axes also solid lines, as well as diagonals will be solid because of the presence of mirror planes on these two respectively. Okay, after that I'll draw the symmetries on the particular axis as well as on the diagonals. So this is four fold symmetry, this is lens of two fold symmetry on diagonals as well as axis. Okay, so now if I am taking a motif here, this is our motif. Okay, now mirror plane is present on C axis, so the reflection of this face will be as it is behind this board. Okay, if the plane of reference is this, a particular face is here, this is a face. Okay, so this plane will be reflected as it is behind this board also. So I am representing this plane or this face as a dot here. So I have to represent the face which is behind this plane of reference as a open circle. Okay, because this is behind the plane of reference. Okay, after that I will see if I want to satisfy the symmetry of four-fold axis, I can do that also. But if I want to start with the diagonals or axis, I can do that also. So I am encountering this mirror plane first. So because of the presence of mirror plane, I am getting the same image here. Okay, again I am encountering mirror plane, I am getting the same image here. Again mirror plane is present, and again mirror plane is present. Okay, so this is the basic structure or the HM symbol of this particular class. So if you want to see the HM symbol with the help of the crystal, so these are the basic crystals. This crystal is for the 4 bar. Okay, we have discussed the crystal of 4/m. The face which is here is reflected as it is here. So we are representing that face with a dot and a open circle. Similarly for this face, a dot and a open circle. For this face and this face, for the face which is behind, that is open circle. So this is the proper HM symbol of the class 4/m. Okay, so this is the HM symbol for class 4-bar, which we have already discussed earlier, and this is the HM symbol of 4, and the crystal for the particular 4 is this one. Okay, so these are the basic crystals and the crystallographic structures of the HM symbol, or a particular class of HM symbol, that is tetragonal crystal system. Okay, so we are finishing this class here. Thank you.